this is the family of Cliphonce Nyango Omondi, who passed on in the KDF chopper crash. We are planning to bury Cliphonce on 3rd of May 2024. So far, the family is trying to do the preparations for the burial. We have our brothers and relatives of Cliphonce in Nairobi that visits KDF offices. So there are people, our people in Nairobi do that, but not us directly. But they tell us the communication between the employer and the family members who are based in Nairobi. So that touches there. There are certain aspects of military practice that we are not aware, or we just hear about them. But now that day, when they come here, part of the burial will be trying to put those things into practice, depending on his rank. There is usually firing of guns. There is the idea of him being dressed in military uniform. We don't have control over that because he's one of them. There'll be some element of marching, and therefore we are waiting to see what they'll do. But the family has got shortage of what they need to make that burial worth the status of the person we want to bury. We need resources, items, foodstuffs, chairs, water, and other things that are necessary for a burial. We have not yet got those equipments or those facilities, and therefore we are appealing to well-wishers, even if it's the government, even if the county government, that can come to our aid so that we give Cliphonce a decent burial.
He was young, but very bright. And at his age, he had even taken some children, rather, to school. He has left around four pupils at school. And due to the smallness of this home, we are planning to bury him on the same date as he has said, on 3rd. But the ceremony will be done at the primary school. That is Ndio Primary School.
Omba serikali wafanye vile walisema, tujue chanzo cha hii mkasa ili moyo yetu itulie. Huyu ndugu yangu bado mdogo, lakini alikuwa na moyo ya kusaidia. Hata sahii kuna watoto amepeleka shule, amechukua gharama yao. Mungu amemleza roho yake mahali pema poponi.
Hiyo siku tulikuwa na chama kama mashemeji wa Cliff, na hiyo siku, hiyo same date, na hiyo ilikuwa around saa saba na 36. Cliff alinitumia pesa ya chama juu tulikuwa na chama ya nyumbani. Kufika saa moja nilipata simu kutoka kwa shemeji wake Vivian ati Cliff amekufa. Nilikuwa na huzuni, sikukuwa na cha kufanya. So naomba serikali atusaidie juu tumepoteza Cliff kama baada angali mchanga sana. So tuko na huzuni sana sana kama familia. Naomba well-wishers, watu wote watusaidie kwa yale ambayo tuko nayo.
Cliff was a good boy. He was very polite, and in fact he died when we were not aware that he was going to die. We were not prepared for that. But since he has died, so there is nothing we can do. We are only ready to bury him, and we wish him, we ask God to put him where he belonged to.